this solemnity of our Blessed Mother, her assumption, we're reminded just how much she can help each one of us in our daily life. There's a good example of that in a true story. Douglas Hyde was once a dedicated communist and former editor of the communist newspaper in London. As the editor, he began to read up on the Catholic Church in order to tear it down in his writings. But something happened to him. As he read, the more he read about the church, the more intellectually convinced he became of its truth. But he could not yet bring himself to believe something was holding him back. Then one day, he was going to work in London on the daily commuter train. When the train arrived at the Ely Place station, he saw a sign that he'd seen 100 times, St. Elder, Ethelbra's Catholic Church. He decided to get off the train and go to it. When he arrived, he sat up in the last pew wondering what strange power had brought him here. Suddenly, a teenage girl came in. She walked down the center aisle and went straight to the statue of Mary. As she passed, he noticed the troubled look on her face. The girl knelt at Mary's feet for a long time. Then she got up and left the church. As she did, he noticed that the troubled look was gone. She was totally at peace. When she had gone, he decided to do what she had done. Take his Bible to Mary. He knelt down and looked up into the face of the Virgin in the statue. He wondered how one prayed to Mary. These are his exact words written in his book titled, I Believe. How did one pray to our Lady? I did not know. At last, I heard myself mumbling something which seemed appropriate enough when it began, but petered out, becoming miserably inappropriate. But it did not matter. I knew my search was happening. Outside the church, I tried to remember the words I had said, and almost laughed as I recalled them. They were those of a popular song. Oh, sweet and lovely Lady, be good. Oh, Lady, be good to me. Mary is indeed our sweet